Welcome to the second video on dimensional analysis. This one is going to cover the metric system. Unless you were raised around the US customary system, the metric system is often easier because its units are extremely consistent. They will just have prefixes that evenly carry over to any unit, and it actually turns out that the digits never change. All you actually have to do to convert from one metric unit to another is move the decimal point. If you do that correctly, your digits will still be the same. For instance, if I look at 3271 milliliters, if we do this problem correctly, since we're converting from one metric unit to another, our final answer will still have those four digits, 3, then 2, then 7, then 1. Again, we want to position the units to induce the milliliters to divide out, replaced with liters. That means that I will put the milliliters on the bottom, and I will put the liters on top. We also know that 1,000 milliliters is the same amount of liquid as 1 liter. With this conversion in place, we take the milliliters and divide. And if I take 3271 and divide by 1,000, I get 3.271 liters. This even works with lesser known metric units. So for instance, we can convert 12 hectometers to centimeters. You might not have heard of hectometers before, but 1 hectometer is equal to 100 meters. And again, the nice thing about the metric system is that these units remain consistent even if what you're measuring is not meters. For instance, 1 hectoliter is the same as 100 liters. 1 hectogram is the same as 100 grams. And although we'll have no occasion to use it in this class, 1 hectocandela even is 100 candelas. Candelas measure luminous intensity. But as you can see, the units carry over. The prefixes mean the same thing no matter what you measure. And this takes a lot of guesswork out of conversions and adds a great deal of flexibility. So I'm going to set this up, and again, I want to replace hectometers with meters because I know what a meter is. I know that 100 meters is the same thing as 1 hectometer. Similarly, I can replace meters with centimeters, and 100 centimeters is 1 meter. As we do this, we cross the hectometer units out, we can cross the meter units out, and again, we're just going to take 12, multiply by 100, then multiply by 100 again. In so doing, we see that 12 hectometers comes out to 120,000 centimeters. And you can see here in both cases we had the same digits. 3271 had a final answer that still had the digits in that order, 3271. 12 hectometers still has the 1 and the 2, it just has a bunch of zeros after it. Next, we'll look at how US customary and metric intersect with each other, but you will see there's not too much of a difference between that and what we've already done.